Hey, a tweet that mentions me. That means I have to make a video about it because I'm that mature. Let's see what it says here. A lot of these people on the casual side like Gigag seem to be more engaged with the culture and sponging up new perspectives far more than most of the elitist crowd. Yes, because they are casuals, they have no steady opinions. They change every day. So sponging up new perspectives doesn't mean they are doing something better, just means they haven't settled down. Which ironically amounts to these casuals building far more relevant and contemporary insights than insular elitists who build such demanding standards for good and bad, they are unwilling to waste their time on new ideas. But culture doesn't wait for anyone! Whose culture are we talking about here? And why would I need new ideas if the old ones work just fine?
Like writing a book with the pages in literally any order. It's possible, and it sounds impressive when you put it like that, but the end result will be a very bland book.
It passes you by if you're not careful, and so the Digibros and anim snobs and whatever of the world are too busy masturbating to their favorite directors from the 80s to notice what is going on here and now, which is just the sweetest irony. Yeah, it's so ironic that we are stuck in the 80s, and we don't like what's going on here and now, with progressives destroying everything with their new ideas, with epidemics not letting us go outside, and protests where people are pointing fingers at completely irrelevant things, and nobody knows what is going on anymore. Yeah, new ideas. We don't see what's going on right here and right now. We're just stuck in the 80s where things were working out. Why would we elitists want to open our minds to new ideas when the old ones were working just fine?
Why be confined? We don't need that structure. That structure is holding us back.
That structure has kept us going for thousands of years, damn it.